We're going to go on Daf Mesechtes Nazir Daf Nun Ches. Begin at the bottom of Nun Zayin Beis, three lines up at the bottom of the Amud, where the Gemara continues the discussion from the previous Daf. And that is, we got into a conversation yesterday regarding the halacha of Hakafa Kol Aroi Shmo Hakafa, which either was from our Mishnah or from the Mishnah later on, two different sources where Shmuel was saying it on. But we had this halacha when you're not sure if you were a Nazir Tomei or not, like the halacha of our Mishnah, we said, okay, so you bring it mitzad asafek, the carbon tuma, the carbon tara, and then you wait another 30 days. But the Gemara says, hey, what is that helping? But maybe they're not tomei, and you're doing an extra hakafa on the second time around, and you're not allowed to do isra hakafa. So the Gemara Shmuel said, oh, it's be'ish of a cotton. So the Gemara says, why don't you say by gadol and hakafa is called a roish losh ma'akafa? Says the Gemara, from the fact that he didn't say that, obviously, because Shmuel holds hakafa is called a roish ma'akafa, and the Gemara is going to now try to say that this halacha of Shmuel, maybe it's a machlekes tanoim, if you say hakafa is called a roish ma'akafa or not. Everyone's joining today's daf. Some discussing today's daf are this idea of hakafa is called a roish, meaning, if you don't cut off only the payas, you also cut off all the hair on the head, is that considered hakafa? Because really hakafa is to go around, which you're cutting around the payas and you leave the hair on the top. But if you cut off everything, maybe there's not the issur of cutting off the payas or not. That's what the Gemara discusses. Also, the Gemara discusses in great detail regarding the halacha of asei duchel leisasei v'asei. Do we say a positive commandment overrides a negative prohibition of a positive commandment? Meaning maybe not in general. Generally, you say asei duchel leisasei, but not with nasei. But in cases of ein shavu b'koyel, like by Kahanim, where it's not universal, or yeshna b'shei, like by that of Nazir, where you could undo it, maybe those are more lenient isurim, and therefore maybe nasei would be deiche, even a leisasei v'asei. Another drasha the Gemara discusses regarding tzitzis, that min hakonof, that the pasuk says it should be from the type of the corner of the garment, that's what the tzitzis string should be made from, versus the temer pishim could be from for all types of begadim. So we begin the current daf nun zayin mabeis, three lines up at the bottom of the yamad. The Gemara earlier discussed whether hakof is kalorosh me'akof or lav shme'akof. And the Gemara asks and says, lema, let's say hakof is kalorosh, that cutting off all the hair on the head, not just the payas, if that's the issue of cutting the payas, it's not tanoi, it's a machlikis tanoi. What's this machlikis tanoi? So we're going to be doing a lot of drushes today, expositions of psukim, and the first one we started was like this. The Tanoi Bama, learn the braisa. Pasuk says, by mitzayra, it says in the pasuk, "V'gilach es kol sa'aray," that he's going to cut off all his hair. Es roishay, which that's the word the Gemara quotes here in the Brisa. And ves zekonoi ves gabas enov ves kol sa'aray galach. So the Brisa is darshaning the word of l'roishay. The question of the Brisa is matam aloyma. What is this coming to teach us? It's extra because, and these are the words of the Rosh, because it's including kol sa'aray. Later on, we're going to darshan the word zekonai. What's that coming to teach? And gabas einov, the eyebrows that darshans elsewhere for klal prat klal. But again, we have to understand all these words in the pasuk. They're all superfluous. They're all unnecessary. You already said kol sa'aray. Why are you detailing all these things? So our Bryce is discussing specifically the word roishai. Oh, so what's that coming to teach us? Says the Bryce, I'll tell you why. Levishan, because in the pasuk lo yisakifu pa'az roishchem, there's always an iser that not to cut off the payas of your head. So as we continue to have nun chesem and alf, yochul af mitzayra kein. So you would think, okay, same thing would be regarding the mitzayra. That by the mitzayra, you have the same thing that, wait a second, you're cutting off all his hair. He shouldn't cut off all his hair. It says, v'gil chakol sa'aray. Okay, that's regarding all the other hair on his body. That's why I needed Roishai to tell you that, no, he's allowed to go ahead and cut off all the hair on his body, including the payas. Now, the payas on the bottom of the Zayim Abayis says, what's the Gemara trying to say over here? The Gemara assumes right now that, based on logic, I wouldn't need a pasuk to tell me that the mitzvah asay of mitzayra, cutting off all his body hair, overrides the negative prohibition of cutting off payas. Because even what's called the lav hashava b'koil, which is a universal lav, we know the halacha throughout Shas that it's going to go ahead and be deicha. Rather, must be that the chiddush of this halacha is coming to tell me that hakof is kol roish shmo hakofa, meaning really what the pasuk is only coming to tell me is that there is an iser over here. Because to tell me, I say the Chaloisa say that the positive commandment of the Mitzvah Kohen Gadol body here, which includes the pay, is I need you to tell me that. Veis Medach. No, I needed to tell you that it's an Isser, that it's being Nidche. And that's what the Reisha is coming to tell you, that even the Mitzvah is going to be able to cut off, meaning that's a Reisha, you would think the Mitzvah cannot cut off his payas. Tamalayim Reisha. So you see that this Manda Amar holds HaKafet Kal Reishma HaKafet. Yeah, I would say all the year besides the payas. The payas is asr. But even though Tay is saying it's not really true, I would know Asid the Chaloisa, but I needed to say that it's asr to tell me that I'm going to give the klal of Asid the Chaloisa, say over here, to tell you that you are allowed to do it. I needed to tell you that you're allowed to do it, and that's teaching me that it was asr, and then I'll say Asid the Chaloisa. Now, that's one price, okay? We want to say it's a machlekes tanoim. So that's one, that's the first price. But Tan Yidach, there's a second price that says the same word, Roshay. This word of Reishai by Metzera, which I know we're going to cut off all his hair. Why are you mentioning his head and his beard and his eyebrows? So we're discussing the word Reishai. Matamal, what's it coming to teach me? Now this Braisa teaches something else. Not what we just said. It says by the Nazir. Tar lo yaval Reishai. A Nazir? During his Naziris? You're not allowed to put a razor. You're not allowed to cut the hair on his head. Okay. Yochalav Nazir Metzera again. You would think, what happens if a Nazir is a Metzera? Okay, Anakim, the Mitzvah has to cut off all his body here? No, you're a Nazir too. You can't cut off the hair on your head. That's why I have to say Reisha in the context of Mitzvah to tell you, even if this Mitzvah is a Nazir, who a Nazir is not allowed to cut off his hair, nope, you're going to cut off the hair on his head. Okay, says the Gemara, my love, isn't this Tanoi here, Machlekes Tanoim? What's the Machlekes Tanoim? Says the Gemara, I'll tell you. Laman Dama Min Nazir, according to one, the second brayse that we just quoted, that was telling me the chiddush of this pasuk of Reishai ben Metzera is telling you the halacha regarding Nazir, ksaver he holds, hakafas kalaraish, loishma hakafa. Cutting off all the hair in the head is not considered the isser cutting of the payas. So as the Rush explains, therefore, for Metzera itself, I don't need a pasuk. Meaning, the first Braisa told me, why do you need to say by Metzera Reishai? Oh, because you can't cut off the hair in the head. It's named off the payas. Nein, it's not taking off the payas. There's no Issa Kafa. You're cutting off all the hair in the head. That's not the Issa of cutting off the payalach. That's only if you only cut off the payas, but you leave the rest of the hair. So I don't need, like the first Braisa said, to teach me the chiddush that Loisa Kifa Paz Reishai, I would think the Metzera Reishai. No. So therefore, he's going to explain it by Nazim Metzera. Where there's a lav of a nazir, and nazir's not allowed to cut off the hair as a head. And in the mitzvah, say, of gadol peri, they have to grow the hair long. So, so what's the pasuk telling you, my Reishai? Not peilach. Lemetchi es loisa say vasei. That you can override the negative prohibition and the positive commandment of nazir, who is not allowed to go ahead and cut off the hair on his head. That's what the second braisa held. Because he held that kafas kalachaysh is loishma hakafa. Not the issur of cutting the pace. Oh, but the idach sub at the time the first price he held. Oh, no, hakavaz kalareish mahakafa. There is an issur of cutting a pace. I didn't give you cut all the hair on your body like the Mitzera does. Oh, so b'chiasi kras. So when I needed the pasuk by Mitzera, is lemitchi lav greide. Is to say that you could even just override the negative prohibition of cutting of pelech. Oh, so like the Rush explains, since you need the pasuk to tell me that you could just override just a negative prohibition, I can't tell you for lois say and I say. The one who learns out that it's teaching you of a mitzvah is a nazir, he's teaching you that you could override a lois say and I say, which is forbidden for a nazir to go ahead and shave off his head. I can't tell you that. I needed to teach you just simply a lois say of not cutting off payas. Because I hold a covered kala reish mahakafa, says the Tana of the first braisa. The second braisa held, no, it's not considered hakafa, so I don't need to teach you that. So, okay, by default, what's left? I'm left with just teaching you Nazim Etzecha, which is even less to say, but I say. So, seemingly, the halacha of Shmuel is a machlekes tanoim. If I cover Kalaresh Mahakov or not, is the reason why, it's again, it's a little complex, but why these tanoim are darshaning from Esreishoi, either from Etzecha in the parasha to tell you that he could do the Isra of cutting the payas, or the Isra of if this Metzecha is also a Nazir that is violent, less to say, but I say that he could override that. Would depend on if they hold it through the Isser cutting of payas when you're cutting off all the hair on his head, not just the payas. That's what the Gemara wanted to say. Amar Rav, he says, nein, not necessarily. The Kulam, I can tell you that according to everybody, Hakavas Kalagaish, Loishma Hakava. Cutting off all the hair on the head is actually, like we had explained for Shmuel, meaning not like Shmuel. The everyone agrees it's not considered cutting off the payas. Okay, so V'chiyasik Ra, then the question now becomes, according to the Tana of the first Braisa, according to the Tana of the second Braisa, that makes sense. If cutting off all the hair in the head is not considered cutting off payas, so he said, so it doesn't have to teach me Lisa Kifu, so you're left with a Nazu that's a Mitzayla, which is overriding a Lisa Basay. But according to the first Braisa, if Hakaf is Kalagosh, Loshma Hakaf, why do I need to have a Pasig that permits you of Lisa Kifu Pas Reishrim? So he says a very interesting answer. We're talking about Kagoin Shehikif. First he cut off the payas, Ulub Saif Gilach, and then at the end he cut off all the hair on his head and of his body. Ah, so that's what the Gemara explains. Kivin di lugalche bechad zimna. Since he would go ahead and cut off in one shot, loy mechayiv, he wouldn't be chayiv. So ki hikiv l'pesav gilach. So even when he cuts off the pace and then he cuts the shapes of all the hair on his head, nami loy mechayiv, he's also not going to be liable because the pasuk by mitzayra tells you that it's going to be doicha. Now, even though it's possible to fulfill both, for example, if you just shave off all the hair on your head, still, that's what we're saying, that the mitzvah says, say, of the gilach is reishai, is going to be deicha v'loisa say, of loisa kifu pas reishchem. So, again, you're right, when you cut off all the hair in your head, everyone agrees, loisa ki, there's no iser, hakav is kalach loish ma'akavah. We thought it's the machalikis tanoim of these braces. Like, no, no, no. Everyone agrees that there's no iser of loisa kifu. So why does the first Bryson need me to tell me that Reisha teaches you that it's Leisa Kifu? Yeah, it's telling me if Yutaka did the Pelech first, and then you did all the hair in the head. Which, Yutaka, you took off the pace. You didn't do it all the hair. But since if I would do it all at one shot, so the Pasuk is telling me that I'm allowed to do it that way too. So the Gemara says, yeah, just to cut off the pace. So the Gemara doesn't like this. Is it really possible that Pasuk is letting you cut off the payas? Reisha is teaching me that you be over loisa kifu if you first cut off the payalach and then you shave off the hair of the head? But that's not true. Rosh Lakish has a klal that says, kamokim shat the moitziah seba loisa, say, wherever you find a opposing positive commandment and negative prohibition, so it goes like this. If you can fulfill both the positive commandment and its negating negative prohibition, so mutav, that's the best way. Try to avoid that they contradict each other. Then lav, if you can't avoid it, the yovei aseve yitches leisase. Then the positive commandment will override the negative prohibition. So the Gemara's question essentially is, wait a second. You can do this without violating this or cutting off the payas. You could just shave off all the hair in the head. You're telling me everyone agrees that kafas kalarash loishma hakov. It's not the ism cutting off the payas. So you're telling me that the Pasuk is letting you with Reisha to tell you that if you first cut off the Pelech and then you do the whole head, then we'll let you do that? We don't let you do that. It's only when it's impossible, then it'll override. But it's possible, Rish Lakish has a klal deter and never lets you do that. So how could you tell me that's what Reisha is coming to teach me? Sela rather says the Gemara, no. Okay, right, let's go the other way around. I don't want this to be a machlekes tanoim, but instead of being everyone holds Hakav is kala Reish, Loishma Hakav, and not like Shmuel, I can tell you the kulam that according to everyone, hakav is kalagosh shema hakava. That actually, when you shave off the hair of the head, everyone agrees that it is considered the isra of cutting of the payas. Wait a second. According to that, how do we understand the tana of the second brisa? Uman the mukim lekrola mitchilosa sevase. According to one that says that the pasuk is talking about by mitzayra. Why say Rashi to tell you that if this mitzayra is also a nazir? Which by a nazir it says that he's not allowed to put a razor on his head, and that there's a mitzvah say of growing his hair long. Wait a second. How could you tell me the pasuk is talking about reisha to include a mitzvah that's a nazir, which is overriding a loisei va'asei? But wait a second. Lav grei de manale. Where does he know a generic loisei? Because as the Rashi explains, if you don't know loisei from somewhere else, how could you explain the pasuk of Reisha Mamitzaira to allow you to override a loisei va'asei when there's a regular loisei va'asei of cutting off the payas, which you're telling me is, everyone agrees cutting off even all the hair of the head is the issue of cutting the payas. Where do you know that source from? Where do you know a seikh b'deicha loisei va'asei that you're not darshaning Reisha for that? You're darshaning Reisha to, if he's also a nazir that's overriding a loisei va'asei, how can you go so far? Where do you first know the Isra that you could even cut off the Peiluch of the Leisase? Oh, says the Gemara, that's not difficult because actually Yalaf Megidilim. He knows Leisase Dech Leisase from elsewhere, Pasuk in the Devarim, from the Mitzvah of Tzitzis. Because the Amakra, the Pasuk says, before the Mitzvah of Gedilim Taslach Megin Tzitzis, says Leisal Beshatnes, you're not allowed to wear a forbidden mixture of wool and linen. Not, but time you learn the Braisa. It says in the Pasuk Leisal Beshatnes, don't wear Shatnes. But ha, the next pasuk tells you in the tzmichas, in the continuity, but gedilim taslacha mehem, but tzitzis you can make from them, meaning from wool and linen. Ah, so you see that the assay of tzitzis is doicha do leisase of climb. So that I already know assay doicha leisase. So therefore, the time of the brisa says of the second brisa says I don't need reisha to teach you that. The mitzvah assay of mitzayru could override the isra of leisakiva of cutting a payas. That's assay. The leisay, I know that from tzitzis already. So what does Rashi come to teach me? It comes to teach me this halacha of assay doicha leisase ve'assay. Okay. Now this is again one of those drasha type of dafim. So the Gemara goes back and says, "Amad denafkele." According to the one that learns that assay doicha leisase me Rashi, the town of the first brisa, the town of the first brisa which we started the daf with said. What does Rashi teach you by Mitzayra? I know you have to cut off all the hair on this head, on this body. Why say the hair on this head? Oh, because it says Loisei Kifa, now cut off the payas. So he's coming to teach you it's Asei Dechal Loisei. So the question is, my time Aloy Nafkele Megadilim. Why doesn't he learn it out from the Mitzvah of Tzitzis? Because, as Tosi explains, he says, regarding the idea of telling me HaKofas Kalareish Shmo HaKofa, which is how we start off the daf with, that, wait a second, maybe you know Gedilim Taslacha. Maybe you know that Aseh is Doicha Leisei. But maybe you needed to learn that from Reishai, that you need the mitzvah of the mitzvah cutting of his hair to be Doicha Leisei of cutting with the pace to tell you that it is an Isser. I needed to tell you that it's going to be Doicha, not because of, I know Aseh Doicha Leisei, but I would have thought that there's no Isser in the mitzvah even cutting off his pace because it cuts off all the hair in his head. And therefore, I need the inference of kavas kalaresh ma'kava, and that's his taste. So the Gemara at this point says that you don't need a pasuk for, because the Gemara understands that enough from svara. You think because you're adding on to cut off, you're not going to be chayav for cutting off the payas? Just like the one who explains the pasuk for aleisa seva asei, which is that of Nazir, he holds, of course, it's called hakafa from svara, not like the Gemara originally understood that I need a pasuk to let me know that a kavas kalaresh ma'kava. That's how Tais explains what the Gemara at this point is asking. It's saying, okay, so according to that man the Amar, that he's learning out the reisha to tell you that you could cut off the payas. Why? Why do I need it? That's Aseh Doicha Leisei. Why can't I learn that from tzitzis? So Amalach, he would tell you that actually the pasuk that Gedilim Taslach is not teaching you Aseh Doicha Leisei. It's actually teaching you something else, like the Rava, who the Asa. What's the teaching of Rava? So the Rava Rami. Rava had posed a contradiction. On the one hand, Ksib, the Pasuk says, V'nosnu al tzitzis ha-kanaf. And they're going to place it on the tzitzis of the kanaf of psil, which sounds like that min kanaf, that from the type of fabric that you have the corner of the garment, that's the exact type of fabric that the psil, that the string, should be a psil tchelis. That it should be, it sounds like, from whatever type of fabric is the corner of the garment, whether it be silk, whether whatever it's going to be, that's how you should make the tzitzis strings. Now, on the other hand, Uksiv, the Pasuk says, Gedilim Taslacha, Tzemer Pishtim Yachtav, the Pasuk says, Leisil Beshatnes Tzemer Pishtim Yachtav, and the Pasuk that's right after that says, Gedilim Taslach. So, it says, wool and linen together, and then you have right after that the pasuk of making tzitzis. So haketzad. So what does that mean? Is tzitzis made out of wool and linen? We read semer pishlam yachtav as if it's part of the pasuk gedilim taslach, even though it's really part of the pasuk of shatnez, but it's right next to the pasuk of gedilim taslach. We read as if the tzitzis should be made out of wool and linen. So haketzad. Which one is it? Are tzitzis strings made out of wool and linen, or are they made out of the type of fabric that the garment's made out of the min of a kanaf of the corner of the garment? Ah, so says the. Says Rava like this, Tzemer Pishtim, when you take wool and linen, oh, those tzitzis strings, Paitim Del Exempt, Bein Beminon. Whether it's the same type, meaning if you put a wool string on the wool garment or the linen string on the linen garment, that's going to exempt it. And Bein Shaloi Beminon. Whether if you're using for some type of a silk or some other type of fabric, that, because as Taisa points out, According to Rava, those types of fabrics are also biblically obligated. As it sounds like in the Gemara, Shabbos of Chavzayim Abay, so I could be telling you a drasha from the Torah to tell you regarding other fabrics. Now, that's why the Torah tells you that Tzemer Pishtim Yachtav is Gedim Tazlach, because yet tzitzis could always be made out of wool and linen. But Sharmin and other types of fabrics, B'min and Patron, meaning if you take a silk string, that will exempt a silk garment. But Shalei B'min and in a Patron, but if it's not that type, it's not going to exempt it. But, as Tosa points out, for Klein but tzitzis, to tell me that Aseh is Deich Aleseh, that I don't know from over here. I'm not telling you Tzemer Pishtim Yachtav near Gedim Taslach to tell you that, Tzemer Pishtim Yachtav is Kalayim. And Gedim Taslach and Tzitzis to tell you, Aseh Deich Aleseh, that Mitzvah Aseh of Tzitzis overrides negative prohibition of Kalayim? No. I'm using this pasuk to darshan something else. I'm coming to darshan that Tzitzis strings could always be out of wool and linen. Nothing to do with the shatness linen and wool. So therefore, that's why answers the Gemara, the Tana of the first Braisa, learns that from Reishoy to teach you that you could override the negative prohibition of Sekiv Pasuk Reishchem, which is just to say Dechalese, because he doesn't have it from Gedilim, Tas Lachab. Then the Gemara says, V'hai Tana, again, it's one of these Drasha type of sugyas. The Tana of the first Braisa, the Mapik L'Reishoy L'Lav Greda. Again, what does he do with Reishoy? He says, Reishoy teaches you that you could cut off the hair on the head. Hello, I know the Mitzvah cuts off all the hair on his body. Why do you tell me on his head? No, when he cuts off the hair on his head, what's he cutting off? He's cutting off his payas also. So that's teaching you that just a negative prohibition, positive commandment of Aseh to cut off all the hair on his body over a negative prohibition covering the payas. But then the question then becomes, the osi Aseh, v'dochi asloi Aseh, v'aseh, that a positive commandment could override a negative prohibition and a positive commandment, where it's not universal. Because when it's universal, we actually don't say, Aseh Deich Aleseh V'Aseh. When it's a non-universal Isser of Leis Aseh and Aseh, Menolon, where do we know that the Tan, the first Braisu, would tell you that it would be Deich? So says the Gemara, Nafkele Mizikane. We learn it out from, as the Gemara is going to explain, from the word there in the Metzaira, where again, it's also extra the words not only of Reishai, but we said it's also extra the word of Zikanai. I know, it says Kalsara, what? So we were just discussing up a ton of the hair on his head. It also talks about the hair on his beard. Now, Tosfos says, wait a second. Why is the Gemara asking such a question? Why is it so obvious to the Gemara that the time the first Bais would hold that Aseh is Doicha, Lois Aseh Va'aseh, even Shein Hashav Bakal? All this time that says is Aseh Doicha, Lois Aseh. Says Tosfos, what you could say is that if you think to say that Aseh is not Deich Aleseh V'Aseh when it's Ein Hashav B'Kol, when it's not a universal Isser, like Kain is not a universal Olam V'Kahanim, if that's the case, so according to the one who learns out that Reisha teaches you just a negative prohibition, and he doesn't darshan it from Gedilim, from that of Tzitzis, so this that we know throughout Shas, that Aseh is Deich Aleseh V'Aseh even when it's Shav B'Kol, meaning a universal Isser, we didn't know that from. Meaning, if you're going to know it from Hakafa of cutting off the payas by the Metzaira, wait a second, that's not Shav Bakal. When it's non-universal Isser, that's a Leichta, it's a lesser Isser, maybe there are Aseh Kebi Deicha. Who would say that you could say even for a general Leis Aseh? Obviously, says Taisis, what the Gemara understood is that no, you don't need this Pasuk of Aseh Deicha Leis Aseh of Mitzayra for itself. Because even a Lav Aseh, it would be Deicha when it's in the Shav Bakal. As the Gemara is going to explain right now, from Zekanai. If that's the case, so then Reishoy Bakov is really extra. And therefore, if it's not really teaching me anything regarding Einish Shav Bakol, it's going to teach me regarding Shav Bakol, very interesting cheshbon that Taisa says. So therefore, it's obvious to the Gemara, and that's what the Gemara is asking, Menola, where do we know that Aseh is Deich Aleseh V'Aseh when it's not Shav Bakol? Because I know that this over here by Metzayra has to be extra, and not teaching me for Einish Shav Bakol, which Metzayra is not Shav Bakol, not everyone's a Metzayra. So that's what I needed to tell me, even when it's Shav Bakol. Which Tosfos just points out that the sugya in the first paragraph of Yevamos holds like the way our Gemara understands according to the Havamina, that the Pasuk of Reishoy has come to teach me, yeah, actually that Hakava is called Reishma Hakava, and not like the Baskon of our sugya here that we know from Svara, like we explained, and it's teaching me other things. But that's why the Gemara is assuming, as Tosfos just explained in the Cheshbon, why this Manda Amma that's teaching me that Reishoy is teaching me that you could over Leisei Kifu, which is just a regular Aseh Deich Aleseh, where does he know Aseh Deich Aleseh V'Aseh when it's in Shav Bakal? So the Gemara says he knows it from Zekanai. What does this mean? The Tanakh learned the Braisa. It says in the Pasuk Zikane, which again is the Pasuk we were expounding on this whole daf, that it says on the seventh day, he cuts off all his hair, and he cuts up the hair on his head, that we darshan as Reisha. Now we're darshaning where it says Vezikane. The question about Tamalema, what's the Pasuk coming to teach me? Again, it already said he cuts off all the hair on his body. Why do I need a special wording to say he cuts off the hair of his beard? Oh, says the Braisa Lafisha Nemar, because since it says by Kahanim, it gets confusing sometimes with all these different psukim to remember which the Pasuk was said. But it says by Kahanim, which really it's universal, but it says by Kahanim specifically, Ufa'asa Kahanim lo igalechu. The corners of their beards they're not allowed to shave off, meaning the issa that we know for cutting off our beards, it says specifically by Kahanim. Okay, so Yochalav Kohen Mitzayra Kain, you would think that even a Kohen that's a Mitzayra, where? There's an iser of loisase of hashchas of cutting the beard. There's also a mitzisase, and that's why he's picking specifically Kahanim, of kedoshim yiyu. A Kohen, when he cuts off his beard, is more than just a regular Yisrael of the iser of loisase shchis. It's also a mitzisase. He has a mitzisase of kedoshim yiyu, that all his loisase are like positive commandments. Now, Ayat says, v'gilach kol sa'ar, he has to cut off all the hair in his head. I would say that's when it falls out on its own, but you're not allowed to go out and cut off, shave off the beard. So you would think that this that it says that a Kohen cannot cut off his beard is even if he's a Mitzayra. Tamoloima Zikonoi. That's why it says Zikonoi to say name. Even if you're a Kohen, and by you cutting off your beard, you're violating a loisase and I say, Shteitin Teirem and Mitzayra, as Zikonoi. To tell you that I don't care. Cut off your beard anyway. Mitzayra has to cut off all the hair on his body. So that's how this mandama knows, hey, wait a second, that's a loisase vase. That's how he knows that ase, like mitzvah, will be deicha, loisase vase. Okay, then the Gemara says, mandama, the Tana, the second brisa, that learns out, literally, she teaching you laase, beloisase, as we said, he learns it out for if a mitzvah is a nazir, which is overriding a negative prohibition in an ase. So then the question is, leilif mizikane. Why is he learning that from Reisha? Why doesn't he learn that from Zikana, which is teaching me loisase vase? Says the Gemara all the time, according to your reasoning, I could ask you back. The Kamlum ba'alma this that we know in general as a Ketin Tamid Beis. Deloi osiase v'dochas loisase vase. We know in general that a positive commandment does not override a negative prohibition that also has a positive commandment with it. Why not? Leilev mekein dedeichi. Why not learn from Kayin, like you just told me, that you see by Kayin mitzayre, it is overriding it, a loisase vase. Why don't you say in general, say dech loisase vase? Ella rather. What's the pshat? Meaning his kasha is like his answer, it's rhetorical. Mikoin lo yafinon. You obviously don't learn that from Kohen. Why not? Because malakoin, what do you find by Kohen? Shekin lav shein shabba koil. Kohen is not a universal halacha. It's only for kahanim. So you can't learn that out through tekala terekula. Okay, so that's my answer too. Nazi mikoin, namal lo yalav. I'm not going to learn out the halacha that I'm learning out from Esreishai, which teaches you that the Mitzera that's a Nazir could override the Nazir's Loise Vase. Why can't I know that from Kayin, from Ezikonai, which teaches me a Kayin that's a Mitzera? No, I can't. Because a Kayin Shekain Lav Shein Neshav Bakoil. It's not universal. And therefore, I need to have Reisha to teach me specifically for Nazir because I can't learn out from Kayin, which I know from Ezikonai. Because Kayin is not Shavakoil. So it's lesser. So maybe that's where you could be Deich Loise Vase. But by Nazir, that's not considered a Lav Shein Shavakoil. All of Klal Yisrael could be a Nazir. So therefore, that's why I would need a special limud of Esreishai to teach me that you could even be Deicha, a stronger Loisei Vasei. I could even override something more powerful, a Lav Hashav Bakoil of Nazir. I wouldn't have known that from Kain. Now, which Taisa says, the Gemara really could have asked right now, then why don't you learn that from Nazir to everywhere else? You're calling me a nazir, which tastes it's a shaila how we qualify if it's a lava shav b'kol or not. But the Gemara is assuming it is. So why don't you say that you can learn that asay derech leisav asay even shav b'kol because nazir shav b'kol? So Taisa says, okay, lamaskan that works out anyways because anyways the Gemara is going to shortly ask and say that nazir is not either great to learn that because nazir is yeshna b'she'ela. You could undo the isra anyway. You could just go to the rav. It's no more isra anyway. So. But the Gemara could have asked that right now. But says the Gemara, okay. Uman de mukim lahai reishai. According to the Tanva, the second Braisa, who explains that reishai by Metzeira is teaches you regarding benazir. And we learn out kayin from nazir. Because
Nazir is even shavu b'koil. And tlisay has idukh alisa b'asay. So wait a second. Loma li zukonoi. Why do you need zukonoi then? You could learn that from Rishay. Which Tosfos says, really, the Gemara's question is not really appropriate because, what do you mean? That's Heshita that we said that you're not learning out from that. Meaning the Zekanai said, according to the Mandama, Reishai Benazir, Tosfos says it's also changing the wording because before we learned, he said, Lamandamapag Reishai La'asei V'loisasei, and now we're learning it, we're calling it differently than what it is. Al Kaponim, the Gemara Shaila is, if you're explaining Reishai by Nazir, so then what do you need Zekanai for? What is Zekanai coming to teach me for regarding Koin Mitzayra, Loisei V'asei, if I know already from Reishai by Mitzayra, it teaches me Nazir, that's Aloy Sasei and Asei, that's even Shavu B'Kol, even that I could override. Says Gemara, you're right. He's not learning out Zekanai to teach you, and that's what his Shita, he's not coming to teach you Aloy Sasei V'asei. We only said that according to the Mandama first Brisa. So it's like an interesting way the Gemara is asking it. But Al Kaponim, the Gemara is saying, okay, what does he do with Zekanai? So the Gemara says he needs it for something else. Zekanai Matam Aleima. Fishing them because there's a pasuk by Kahanim. It says the corners of their beards, you're not allowed to shave off. Now, okay, Yachlav Kohen Mitzayra Kain. You would think a Kohen's not allowed to cut off the corner of his beards, even if he's a Mitzayra who has to cut off all the hair in his body. Tamaloyma Zekanai, it teaches you, no. Zekanai teaches you that he cuts off the corners of his beard. Now, we're not done yet with explaining what is he using it for.
Because if so, then the whole Gemara wouldn't be shy. How do you know that because a Kohen can't cut his
pay? Right, so we're not saying that here yet. We're saying that...
How do you know that it's an Isser on everybody?
Oh, no, that's a separate pasuk. There's a separate pasuk that says, by Klal Yisrael, that they're not allowed to cut off the corner of their beards. It says by Klal Yisrael also. Like the Kiva Pasuk Reishchem is talking about by everyone.
It says it twice.
Does it say it twice? It says by Klal Yisrael. This pasuk of is talking about by pasuk kanim. It's not talking about the corners of the head. It's talking about the corners of the beards. Pasuk kanim lo yigalecha. The pasuk we're quoting right now by kahanim is the corners of their beards. It's by the beard, even though it says the same word payas, but it's a different payas. It's the corners of the beards. So we're just trying to teach you what does he use the kanim for. So the kanim is teaching you. It's not going to teach you regarding Lo Yisasei V'asei, because that I already know from Reishai. So what's it teaching me? It's teaching me something else, as the Gemara is going to say very shortly. We're going to finish the drasha. Zekanai teaches you that even if a Kohen is a Metzeira, he cuts off the corners of his beards. Now, Menon de Betar, how do you know that the shaving of the hair of the Metzeira has to be with a razor, that then it's going to be Doicha, the Lo Yisasei, of cutting off the corners of the beards? Oh, because it's not in the Brisa. It says in the pasuk of Hazakan Legalech, the corners of the beard they shouldn't shave off. Yochalav Gilchabim is Bahaim Yechaib. You think that even if he cuts it off with scissors, that he'd be chayiv for cutting off his beard. Tamalamit says, no, but it's not to destroy. Destroy when you ruin the root. You don't destroy it when you're cutting with a scissor. Oh, but Eloy Tashkas, if I only had the words you now to destroy, Yochaliktim b'malakit b'bechitne chayiv, you would think that even if you also destroy the roots with, let's say, with some other instrument, like a plane, that which is a type of a carpet instrument, that you'd be chayv also, because it's also destroying. No, it says, v'azakun le'galechu. The corners of the beard, now let it cut off. Giluach. Which giluach is like scissors, like something that you use as a cutting instrument that a barber uses. So, wait a second, you have two different psukim. So, eze galech shesh b'ash chasa. What is a hair cutting that also destroys the roots? Ah! Havoim is atar. That's a razor. So, essentially, Akteis explains, what we're learning out from Zekanai is teaching you that Teglachas of Metzirah needs a razor. Because from Reishai of Nazir, I wouldn't know this. Meaning, you're right. From Reishai of Nazir, I know that Asei can be Deich Aloy Seva Asei. That I know. I don't need Zekanai to teach you that according to the Mandam of the second Brisa. But what it is teaching me is that I actually need a razor by the Mitzayra. Because, as the Gemara taught on Daf Mem, a Nazir actually is Chayiv
b'chol mavirim. So if all I used was roishoy, that by mitzvah he cuts off the hair in his head, which I'm telling you, even though he's a nazir in the violin, he loy say basay, yeah, but I would think that would even be with a scissor. Because a scissor you're violating as a nazir, whatever he removes the hair. So I need zekane to teach me that because I know hashchas hazaken is only mitar, as the Gemara explained. So I need zekane to tell me that a mitzvah is going to be doicha, must be that a mitzvah has to use a razor. But then says Taisus, what tzarachin is that when the Gemara asks zekane lamali, why doesn't the Gemara answer tameich, this, that we know that in ase doicha leisa basay, you should learn out from Nazir that's a mitzvah, that it's Daicha. So says Taisus, what do you have to say? That no, you can't learn out from Nazir because it's Shekin Yeshna B'She'elo. So therefore you wouldn't know. And the Gemara is going to actually discuss this right now. The Gemara says, okay, so you explain to me according to the Tanna, the second brace, I already knows from Reisha, I say Dechalise Vasei, Shein Hashem B'Kol, so what do I need to have Zikon? Therefore, that's come to teach me not really so much that it can be Daicha, that I already know from Reisha, just to tell me that you need to have a razor. Oh, for the fact that now I know you need a razor, because now I need a special rebut today, that you can be deicha. Or else I wouldn't need a deicha. But then says the Gemara, okay, going back to the time of the first braisa. According to one that learns out, that what does Reisha teach me is a love grade that only teach me regular negative prohibition. Of loisa kiva paz reishchem. So wait a second. Lomi li lemichtav reisha, v'lomi li lemichtav zikone. The Gemara is asking that just write zikone. Because zikana, I understand to mean whether it means the beard of a kain, whether it means the beard of a Yisrael. And from that I would understand mashma, if all I said was zikana, that would be lamitchi lav grede, that would tell me that it overrides just a regular negative prohibition by a Yisrael, because when the Yisrael shaves off his beard, he's just oiva loisasei. And I would also know a mashma lamitchi loisasei va'asei, because when it's by the kahanim, which that's an explicit pasuk, that he overrides Aloise Vasei. So Hilkuch Shakalu, it would be equivalent when it says that Zakani tells you that the Mitzvah cuts off his beard, you would learn both. So even though Reishai is also a Mikramale, and I don't need it to explain it only by just regular Reishai, and not by Reishai and Nazir, so why is the Gemara asking have Zakani and not Reishai? So as it tells you, there it's different, because by Reishai, it's two different negative prohibitions. You're including the lav of cutting off the payas, that's one problem with Reishai, and then you want to say also lav of Nazir, which is tar lo yaver. So there is not logical to say that the pasuk is going to be including both of these isurim, one being Eloise Se Greid and one being Eloise Vase. But cutting off the beard, it's all one negative prohibition. By Yisrael, it's leshaschas pasuk anecha, mekahanim is pasuk am legelechu, and also nasev, kodeshim hiu. So therefore, it would seem that when the pasuk tells you that the asay of mitzera of zikonai is going to be deicha, the negative prohibition would be whether of a Yisrael or a kahanim, because it's all one prohibition. So therefore, the Gemara is asking, so wait a second, what do I need Reisha for? According to one that learned from Reisha, deicha leisa say, avleisa kiva paz Reisha, I don't need it. I could just say zikonai, which would teach me both a leisa say and a leisa vasay, because it would be referring to Yisrael and kahanim. Now, Rabbein the Peretz brings that now the Gemara could have answered that if I'm going to learn that from just zikonai, you could ask, because that's a lav she'en ha'shav b'kol. Because cutting off the beard doesn't apply to women. And therefore you needed reishai with what's called im eina inyan lav she'en ha'shav b'kol, if it's not something that's for a non-general iser, because I already know that from zikane, therefore I needed l'shav b'kol. So as Taisa, it would seem that the Gemara thought that they're equivalent and that it's going to be chamer loisa say of Hashav Bakoy, like Eloise Vasei, Shein Hashav Bakoy. It's just, he says the Gemara is more lengthy because the Gemara continues on since it wants to come out. It goes through all the different stadim here. It goes through all the different options. The Gemara is asking right now, okay, just say Zakana, I don't need Reishai. So says the Gemara, no, I can't do that. Why not? Because Kayin Min Nazir, Lo Yalof. What happens is, what I tell you, Reishai is coming to teach you. Reishai is coming to teach you that of the Isser of. So the Gemara says like this. Why do I need Reishai and Zikane? Because we said that Zikane is teaching you regarding a Kayin, and Reishai is teaching you regarding Nazir. So says the Gemara, Kayin and Nazir lo yalef. I wouldn't know Kayin from Nazir. I mean, they're both aloy se ba'ase, but I wouldn't be able to know it because shekin yeshna b'she'ela, because by nazir you could ask and undo the whole isra in the first place. And the other way is also true. Nazim mikayin, if I only said zikana to learn the nazim mikayin, lo yov, I wouldn't know that shekin lav shein shabakal, because that's not a universal isra. And uba alma, and in general to say ase derech leze ba'ase, lo yafinu minayhu, I wouldn't be able to learn out from the two of them. Because you could ask Kedamaran, like we said. So therefore, that's why I need to have Roishai, and that's why I need to have Zikana. But the problem with this is, as Tosfos brings from the Ram, is what the Gemara is saying, Kain min nozel yalev, why don't you say that Kain was necessary because of Tar? That you need to have a razor by the Mitzrayim, like we said before. Why are you answering that you need it because you wouldn't know Kain from Nazir? I thought you said the reason why you have to say Zikanai by Kain is not because you can't learn it from Nazir, it's because you want to tell me that Mitzrayim needs a razor. And another question that's more difficult is, if you're reading the Gemara, is that the Gemara asks, according to the one that learns Roishai for just a regular negative prohibition. And what does the Gemara answer? The Gemara answers, oh, according to the one who learns out Roishai to teach you Nazir, you wouldn't know from Kain or Kain from Nazir. What are you talking about? That's the other Braisa. You asked on one brisa, and then your answer, if you notice, the Gemara's answer just like totally shifted on us and went to like the other. That brisa learns that Reisha is not learning out Kayin from Reisha, Nazar from Reisha. He learns out from negative prohibition, Leisa Kivapaz Reishchim. What are you saying? Nazar can't learn that from Kayin, can't learn from Nazar. So, therefore, it appears to the Ram to explain that the Gemara understands right now that since we come out, that Zikna is coming to tell us that you need to have a razor. So, therefore, right now, according to the one that learns that Roishai teaches you on just a negative prohibition, so from where do you know that a Nazir Mitzayra and a Kayin, that the Mitzayra is going to cut off all this here? Obviously, you have to say that it's an explicit pasuk, because the pasuk says Stama. It's told in all situations, whether he's a Kayin, whether he's a Nazir. So if that's the case, so why do you have to write Zikanei? That was what the Gemara was asking. And then, since you're going to say, what do you mean? You need it. You need to tell me that Teglachas HaMetzari needs a razor. On this case, what you could say is that what the Gemara is asking is like this. Why did the Tana have to say that you take Zikane to learn out for a Kayin Metzari that is permitted to cut off his hair? Says Zikane. What's it coming to teach me? You could know that from Reishai. Meaning, because even a Nazir that's a Metzari cuts off the hair of his head, even though it's Alei Seva Asay, because the crow was stomach said. Where from there you could learn out that even the Kayin that's a Kayin, would cut off his beard. Because at this point, the Gemara understands that according to this Tana, they would be equivalent. But the Gemara says, in the Chanami, most definitely he holds that the Pasuk is including everyone. And from Rashi itself, you would learn out that also a Nazir that's a Mitzayra would cut off the hair of his head. And even so, if it didn't say Zikanai, I wouldn't have known the Halacha of Kayin as the Gemara explains, because a Nazir is Yeshna B'Sheila. And if it only says Zikanai, I wouldn't have known Nazir because it's a Lav Sheina Shabakal. So as Taisa, according to this Maskana, it really comes out that the Tana that explained Reisha for Lav Gereda, the truth is we also know from the Lav Vaaseh. So why are you only mentioning the Lav of Hakafa? To tell us his opinion that he held that if not for the Pasuk of Reisha and Zikanei, even a Lav Gereda, I wouldn't have known that the Aseh could be Deichid. Why? Because the Pasuk of Gedilim, he explains like Rava. So when the Gemara ends off and says, Ba'amo lo yafina kedamar, in other words, that you could ask, what do you find by a coin which Allah Hashem Neshav Bekol? And what do you find by Nazir Kenyesh Mesha'ilo? So therefore, that's why you need to have both Reishai and Zikanai. And therefore that you don't know that in to other Yisroim, that you don't say Aseh Dech Alei Sav Aseh. Then says Taisa, begin to say, why don't you learn out both that, from both of them in a Mahatzad? So you can't learn it from Nazir separately, you can't learn from Kain separately, why don't you learn from both of them together, the common denominator? So the Reish says, because you could ask, what you find by the Aseh of Mitzayra, where do you learn this out from? It's by the Aseh of Mitzayra. That says the same mitzvah is deich leis sebasei of Nazir or deich leis sebasei of Kayin. Wait a second, the same mitzvah is so strong because it brings shalom bias. As the Gemara says in Chul Nafkov Mem Aleph, that you would have thought to say the say of tziporim mitzvah should be deich leis sebasei of shluch hakem because of shalom bias, because mitzvah can't be with his wife. So maybe the say is deich leis sebasei in those cases, not in general. Therefore, I wouldn't know to be in general. But Al Kapanim, it was a little bit complex, but Taisa had to address this point. It's important because you read the Gemara, it doesn't make sense. Gemara's asking one mandama, and then the Gemara shifts to the other mandama. Taisa explains how that works out, Lamaskana. Now, a related discussion to this about a cutting off the hair on the person's body, Samar Rav, he says, Mekel Adam Kol Gufa Betar. A person can lighten his whole body with a razor, meaning even his armpits and even by his genital area, there's no problem about Lo Yilbash Geber Semlas Isha that he's doing feminine type of grooming. Now, but regarding the payas of the hair and the beard, obviously Rav's not talking about it. It means the rest of the body, if you want to be take off the hair on the body, you could use a razor. So the Gemara says, basically, we're asking the following b'risa. B'risa says, a maver beis ha-shecha beis ha-erev. If someone shaves off the hair on his armpit or by his genital area, ha-reza loike, he gets lashes because of lo-yilbash gever. The Gemara is going to darshan shortly. You're doing feminine type of activities. So how can you say that you're allowed to do that? Says the Gemara, it's not difficult because the b'risa is toma betar with a razor. If you do it like a razor, the way women shave the hair on their body, that's the issa lo-yilbash. And then you're going to get malchus. Ha, Rav is talking about b'misparayim. He's talking about with scissors. If you take a scissor, you're allowed to trim the hair of your armpits and by the groin area. Says the Gemara, how could you say it? Rav nami b'tar kama. Rav's words were, you could lighten the hair on your body with a razor. Says the Gemara, no, ke'ein ta'al, like a razor. Which, as the Rush explains, that's when you use scissors close to the flesh, that's like a razor. But a razor itself, yes, you would get lashes for. Now, Amr Reb Chiya bar Abba Amr Reb Yechon, he says, Amav beis ha-shecha beis ha-erva. He says, if someone removes the hair of the armpits or of the genital area, like you get lashes. That's what how Reb Yechon says it. So, basically, the Gemara asks from the Braisa, says, wait a second. The Braisa says, Havara seir einim de retire, removing the hair on the body is not biblical. Elim de retire is only rabbinic. So, Taisa points out, really, what are you asking from this Braisa? You could support him from the previous Braisa that said that you do get malchus. But the Gemara preferred to answer, my like and name to come. What does Rabbi Yechon mean when he says you get lashes? It's midrabanan. It's rabbinic lashes. So now the Brisa are not disagreeing. Now, but the place does point out, Rabbi Yechon holds that the issue is even with scissors. Because it sounds like Rabbi Yechon disagrees with Rav. Rav says you're allowed to do it with scissors. Rabbi Yechon says, no, you can't even do it with scissors. And therefore, that would be rabbinically prohibited to go ahead and cut off the hair by the armpits and by the genital area because of this isser rabbinically. And therefore, the makas is makas mardis rabbanon. Thank you to any time for hosting us.